Hello, everyone. Let's continue the class. The third part of antiarrhythmic drugs. In the last class, we have known antiarrhythmic drugs includes four kinds. The first case, sodium channel blockers. In the last class, we have studied 1A. The drug is potent sodium channel blockers, such as we studied quinidine, procainamide, and quinidine mainly used to treat atrial fibrillation and atrial flutter as the first choice agent. 1B, mild efficacy, mild sodium channel blockers, such as we studied lidocaine and phenytoin. And we have known lidocaine is the first choice agent to treat each kind of ventricular arrhythmias. We also studied 1C, the most potent sodium channel blockers, such as procainamide, and this drug is the heavily sodium channel blocker, so have lots of other restrictions, and this drug only used to treat the other antihypertensive antiarrhythmic drugs in effectiveness. We use 1C. Today, we will study the second class of antiarrhythmic drugs, beta receptor blockers. And then, we will study the third class, potassium channel blockers. The last kind, CCB, calcium channel blockers. So continue the class. The second class, antiarrhythmic drugs, they are beta receptor blockers. We know the prototypical agent is propranolol. We use propranolol, we use beta receptor blockers to treat arrhythmias. The first reason, because they are beta receptor blocker. Because these drugs can inhibit sympathetic nerve activity, so the drugs have negative inotropic action. Negative chronotropic action means inhibit conduction, reduce heart rate, used to treat tachycardia. The second reason, because beta receptor blockers can inhibit sodium channel. Just now we have studied sodium channel blockers. Propranolol can block sodium channel, means can inhibit autoresmicity. Because autoresmicity determined by phase 4 by sodium or calcium channel. Propranolol beta receptor blocker also can block sodium channel, so inhibit autoresmicity, mainly inhibit sinoatrial nodal autoresmicity, also inhibit atrioventricular nodal and ventricular ectopic autoresmicity. Block sodium channel, so also inhibit conduction. Beta receptor blockers can inhibit atrioventricular nodular conduction, inhibit ventricular Purkinje fibers conduction. For these effects, we can use beta receptor blocker to treat tachycardia. To treat arrhythmias, for supraventricular arrhythmias and ventricular arrhythmias have good therapeutic effects, especially for sinus tachycardia. Propranolol as the first choice drug. Sinus tachycardia, the first choice agent should be beta receptor blocker. And the beta receptor blocker especially used to treat supraventricular arrhythmias induced by catecholamine increase. Such as fulcrinolithotripsy patients. Fulcrinolithotripsy patients, it is one kind of adrenal gland tumor. This adrenal gland tumor can release more catecholamines and induce arrhythmias, also induce hypertension. Fulcrinolithotripsy patients with arrhythmias, we should give beta receptor blocker as the first choice anti-arrhythmic drug. And we also use beta receptor blocker to treat hyperthyroidism with arrhythmias. Why? Because hyperthyroidism patients, the major symptoms of hyperthyroidism are tachycardia, are hypertension. So we can use beta receptor blocker, inhibit sympathetic nerve activity. We also use beta receptor blocker to treat hyperthyroidism. So now you should know hyperthyroidism with arrhythmias. The best drug should be beta receptor blocker. Okay. In clinic, we use propranolol as the prototypical agent. But in fact, in clinic, we lack high selectivity beta-1 receptor blocker to treat heart and vessel disease. Because high selectivity means lower adverse actions. For example, we can use atenolol, esinolol, and metoprolol and bisoprolol to treat hypertension, to treat anemia, to treat heart failure. This class, we use beta-1 receptor blocker to treat arrhythmias, especially supraventricular arrhythmias. Supraventricular arrhythmias, such as sinus tachycardia, as the first choice. So don't forget, the first choice agent to treat sinus tachycardia is the beta-1 receptor blocker. And high selectivity beta-1 receptor blockers, such as atenolol, esinolol, metoprolol, this drug, compared to propranolol, the adverse action less and milder than propranolol. The third case of anti-arrhythmic drugs, they are potassium channel blockers. Potassium channel blockers can delay phase 3 repolarization by blocking potassium channels. So the duration of action potential and the duration of effective refractory period are obviously prolonged. So the third case, anti-arrhythmic drugs, potassium channel blockers, they are action potential duration prolonger. The drug is amiodarone. Amiodarone obviously block potassium channel, but also can block sodium calcium channels, but also can inhibit alpha and beta receptor. Inhibit sodium and calcium channels, so inhibit phase 4, inhibit autoresmicity. Inhibit sodium channel, so inhibit phase 0 sodium channel, inhibit conduction. Number 3. prolong potassium channel. So, means inhibit potassium channel. Means prolong action potassium duration. Prolong ERP. Obviously, block potassium channel. So, amiodarone. Obviously, prolong action potassium duration and ERP. Because we know phase 0 to phase 3, phase 0 to phase 4, we call this APD. And the major channel is potassium channel. Amiodarone, the third case, antiarrhythmic drugs, block potassium channel, so it prolong ERP 0 to 3. Prolong action potassium duration 0 to phase 4. And we use amiodarone, the third class antiarrhythmic drugs to treat arrhythmias as the broad spectrum antiarrhythmic drugs. Broad spectrum means all kinds of arrhythmias. We can use amiodarone to treat, such as atrial arrhythmias, atrial fibrillation, atrial flutter, atrial tachycardia, and supraventricular tachycardia, pre-excitation syndrome. Amiodarone have good therapeutic effects. Also use amiodarone to treat ventricular arrhythmias, such as ventricular tachycardia, ventricular premature, ventricular contraction, and so on. So the drug amiodarone, it is the broad spectrum antiarrhythmic drugs, can use to treat each kind of arrhythmias, but not as the first choice. Other sections of amiodarone includes induced sinus bradycardia, long-term use damage hepatic function and pulmonary toxicity. And for elderly patients, long-term use can induce corneal microdeposits. And for some patients, use amiodarone will have allergic reaction, such as photosensitization, when kind of skin rash. And the special major adult section of amiodarone is this one. Alternations in steroid function may be induced hypothyroidism, may be induced hyperthyroidism. So steroid function abnormal. The last class, antiarrhythmic drugs, class 4 antiarrhythmic drugs, CCB, calcium channel blockers. We have studied calcium channel blockers. We know two prototypical agents. One is verapamil, the other one is nifedipine. And we also studied verapamil have obviously significantly negative inotropic, negative chronotropic action on heart than nifedipine. So, heart disease, we use the CCB is verapamil. This class, we use CCB to treat arrhythmias. So we use the drug is verapamil. Verapamil can block L-type calcium channel, but also can block R-type potassium channel. So block calcium channel and then inhibit phase 4, inhibit autoreismicity. And calcium channel blockers, we have studied negative chronotropic action, means that inhibit conduction. CCB also block potassium channel, so means prolong action potassium duration, prolong ERP. These are pharmacological effects of calcium channel blocker to treat tachycardia. So to treat tachycardia, the clinical using of CCB mainly used to treat supraventricular tachycardia as the first choice agent. So the question very easy, and you must remember the question is, which drug is the first choice agent to treat supraventricular tachycardia? The right answer is CCB. In CCB, the best drug should be verapamil. Yes, verapamil. The other section we have studied in calcium channel blockers, such as negative effects on heart, so maybe induce heart failure, maybe induce bradycardia. The last case of antiarrhythmic drugs, the other drugs, such as digoxin. Digoxin, later we will study the drug. It is the one kind of cardiac glycoside, major used to treat heart failure. Digoxin is usually used in combination with other agents, such as combination with beta receptor blocker, such as combination with verapamil, such as digoxin should combination with quinidine. To achieve satisfactory resting ventricular rate in treatment of chronic atrial fibrillation, all atrial flutter and supraventricular tachycardia. Because digoxin can inhibit atrial ventricular conduction. So in clinic, atrial fibrillation and atrial flutter, the first choice agent is quinidine, but quinidine must co-administered with digoxin. The last drug is adenosine. It acts at adenosine receptor to slow or block AV atrial ventricular node conduction. Its primary clinical application is to terminate supraventricular tachycardia, because this drug used in several seconds inhibit conduction. So it's to terminate supraventricular tachycardia. In antiarrhythmic drugs, we studied a lot of drugs, and let's summarize. 1A, 1B, 1C, the first kind, such as quinidine, procainamide, lidocaine, phenytoin sodium, flucainamide, encainamide, and they are sodium channel blockers. Second kind, beta receptor blockers, such as propranolol, selectivity beta 1 receptor blocker, metoprolol. The third kind, amiodarone, they are potassium channel blockers, obviously prolong action potassium duration. And the last part, CCB, such as verapamil, diazepam, block sodium calcium channel. And we use them. So, sinus tachycardia, we can use beta receptor blocker or CCB. But in fact, we use beta receptor blocker as the first choice. Atrial premature beats, atrial fibrillation, we can use beta receptor blocker, calcium channel blockers. Class 3, potassium channel blockers, amiodarone. 1A, quinidine, and cardiac glycoside, such as digoxin. Super ventricular tachycardia. Acute patients, we can use beta receptor blocker, calcium channel blockers, cardiac glycoside such as digoxin. Chronic super ventricular tachycardia, we can use digoxin or quinidine. Premature ventricular contraction, we can use procainamide 1C. Amiodarone, the third K class. With acute myocardial infection, the first choice agent should be lidocaine. But digitalis toxicity, we use phenytoin sodium. Ventricular tachycardia, we can use lidocaine. Ventricular fibrillation, we can use procainamide, amiodarone. Oh, maybe you're confused. Oh, teacher, it's too difficult for us. It's very, very difficult. And in fact, let's summarize again. And I think you can remember this. The first one, atrial. Atrial fibrillation, atrial flutter. The first choice drug is quinidine. The second one, sinus. Sinus tachycardia. The first choice agent should be beta receptor blocker, such as metoprolol. The third one, supraventricular tachycardia. The first choice drug should be CCB. ECCB, the first choice drug is verapamil. No matter the reason, each kind of ventricular arrhythmias, ventricular premature contraction, ventricular tachycardia, ventricular fibrillation, no matter the reason, each kind of ventricular arrhythmias, the first choice agent must be lidocaine. Only digitalis toxicity, lidocaine as the second choice. The first choice agent is phenytoin sodium. And bradycardia. Bradycardia, the first choice agent is atropine. The second choice is isoprenaline. Okay? So now I think it's very easy for you. And this class is over. See you next time.